Okay, please put your hands and apparently your pincers together for Lano and Woodley. Guys, couldn't help but notice the outfit. What's going on here?
Well, I told Frank to dress up, although I'm not even sure whether it's Frank, because he's been so slack lately. Maybe he's sent in a proxy. So let's... Is it actually you, Frank? Is it actually you? Is it actually you? It is you.
Yeah, no.
I said we were coming on TV and you should wear your best clothes.
These are my best clothes.
Really?
These are good clothes. I'm actually legally obligated to wear these nippers.
What do you mean, why are you legally obligated?
It's because of the lobster clause in my contract.
Anyway, we're here to talk about Moby Dick, because it's a great show.
Should I assume...
I've seen it myself. I mean, I can see all the jokes coming, so it's quite predictable. but it's a great show.
Well, is that what the lobster thing's about? Is it an ocean reference to the whole...
Yes.
Thing? Let's go with that.
Yes, that sounds good. That sounds good. But it's a classic tale, but we were choosing... You know, we did a show about the Wright brothers. We were talking about War and Peace or... Little Women or Driving Miss Daisy.
We're going to do our version of Little... We should have done that. We should have done Little Women.
I've never said that before in public and I'll never be saying it again. you know, we had to choose. And what's a great way of choosing what to do? Like short straws or eeny, meeny, miny, moe? What's a great way to choose?
Pick a colour between 1 and 7.
What?
W-H-H.
We don't want props on the show, okay? We're doing an interview. Yeah. We're doing an interview with these very important people. No props on the show, okay? No more props. Props, okay? So eat that and learn a lesson. Anyway, Moby Dick is a classic tale. It's a classic tale of revenge because Captain Ahab, you know, he got his leg bitten off by Moby Dick, and then he seeks out revenge, and Moby Dick was his nemesis for many, many years. And have a guess who my nemesis is.
Actually, not bad. One of the nicer origami toys I've snacked on recently, I have to say.
Why have you got props?
Well, because I thought it's fun to, you know...
No, we're not... It's an interview show. You don't need props,
well,
all right?
I thought it could be quite
You use props all the time. It's like a crutch to you.
So a lot of comedians...
frying pans and boxing gloves.
I was just going to say, a lot of comedians like to do social commentary or political stuff. What's with the props? Why are we doing props?
Well, actually, some people, a lot of people think that slapstick is very childish and it's quite, you know, it's lowbrow. But I think it's a highly sophisticated art form. And in fact, you know, for example, with slapstick violence, what you're doing is you're abstracting and you're rarefying the conflict that happens between any two people or community, and you're symbolising it as a catharsis for the audience, you know?
It actually did make me feel better.
It's gone down.
So much drama happens at that end.
We need your care.
It was the sound of it.
Are you all right?
And because I was on TV, I really put my shoulder into it.
So it's highly sophisticated.
It's highly sophisticated.
Yeah. Would you like a chair back?
No, I'm good.
You're good. Colin, you narrate.
Yes, sir.
You narrate the story.
Yes, I do. It's a story. I mean, a lot of productions on Moby Dick is about, you know, Captain Ahab and Moby Dick. But this is a story about... don't give me the wind-up, young man. Unbelievable. This is a story about...
He was either giving you the wind-up or he was just going, that guy's crazy.
It's a story about a short, bald music producer with glasses called Moby and a dick. So, and he plays the role beautifully. It's a gift. I would wind us up.
Don't miss Lano and Woodley.
Don't miss them. Don't you dare miss them. There's lots of shows on at the Comedy Festival, but only one good one. Moby Dick.
Colin and Lobster Frank, where's your mask?
It's down here.
Where is it? This is the worst episode of The Masked Singer ever. Look at that. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much.